Welcome back to Candy's Art World. I'm Candy, and today I'm going to be trying a little bit of calligraphy with watercolor instead of the calligraphy pen. I decided to give making like graph marks on the paper try to see if that helped with my lettering and my letter spacing and all that. I kind of was just figuring it out as I went. It definitely helps having graph lines to help mark out where your letters are and how much space you're taking for each one of the letters and all that. I need to find me a lighter pencil for making these grid marks and stuff, though it'll make it easier on the erasing process, especially with the watercolor. You want to erase as many lines as you can before you watercolor, or they're going to stay. So I decided to write, "Let it snow. We've got hot cocoa." Because we've had two snow days in a row. Instead of being all bummed that I'm stuck in the house, decide to enjoy some hot cocoa instead. Here I am erasing the grid lines, which of course took away some of the lettering, but I go back in and put them back in with the pencil. I'm adding the line for the we've got hot cocoa now. Yeah, I almost misspelled cocoa. That's the good part about using pencil first. You can erase. Here I am adding a couple of mugs of hot cocoa with candy canes. One has marshmallows in it, and the other one has whipped cream. So that way, everybody's favorite kind of hot cocoa will be included in the drawing. When I was a kid, my favorite thing, my grandma would make hot chocolate with marshmallows on top and some buttered toast. Very strange combination, maybe for somebody that's never had it, but it is amazing to dip your buttered toast into hot chocolate. I'm weird, maybe, but it was delicious. I decided to clean one of the palettes of the watercolor so that way I could mix fresh colors and not have anything accidentally get into the colors I was using. I don't do that often because you can reuse the paint that's on there if you're working in the palette in the same color family and stuff. You can use that just by adding water, it comes back to life, so it doesn't waste. But for this, I wanted to have a fresh, clean space to work on. I used a light blue first to try to outline the letterings. I was seeing if this would be easier for calligraphy with a brush than with the pens that I have. It is, but it's still a learning curve, and I decided to use a darker blue for the downstrokes, so that way it just popped a little bit more than just the one color, so it's kind of two-toned. And I worked letter by letter so that way the colors could blend, hopefully. And I always started with the light and then went with the dark back over the downstrokes with the dark. But it is a little easier to get the thicker lines and thinner lines with a brush because if you put very little pressure, you get a really thin line. You add a little more pressure, the more pressure you add, the thicker the line will be. I'm just using a small round brush. The key to this is to not have your brush too wet. You do want some water in the brush. That way, when you add your darker color, it kind of bleeds onto the spot that you want it. But you don't want it really, really wet. Like if you were painting a scene, you'd want way more water in your brush. So this is kind of a drier brush on dry paper. Thank you. I decided to use shades of purple for the word weave. I wipe the palette clean after each different word to keep it clean. And I decided to use shades of green for the word got. I gave the G a long tail that came up and crossed the T for me. I went with pink and red for the word hot. And for the H, I had the cross for the H go over and cross the T as well. It was really cool to add the darker color onto the light or the lighter color, because you could like touch it down and kind of watch the pigment flow onto the wet lighter color. It was pretty neat to watch. For the word cocoa, I went with two shades of brown. I decided to start with the cocoa and the mugs because I already had the brown colors in my brush and on the palette. Thank you. I decided to make it pink, one of the mugs pink, because when you can add more pink, you should add more pink. And I decided, why not a blue cup too, to tie in the blue words. I just used a brush with water to try to blend the two different blues in together. Can't forget to color in the candy canes. I decided to add some snowflakes with the Sharpie on the mugs to bring in the snow part into the picture. And used a blue Sharpie to add some snowflakes onto the blue mug as well. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Have a great day.